Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum friends. In this video, I am going to show you how to design a fuselage of Boeing 737 by using pictures. So keep watching this video till end.
Before going further, let me introduce you to my YouTube channel SolidWorks Tutorials and Engineering News, where you will find a huge quantity of videos regarding SolidWorks and engineering. So please don't forget to press subscribe button and this bell icon for all upcoming video notification.
Let's start. First of all, you have to download the pictures of Boeing 737 from Google. I have downloaded these two pictures from Google for a reference guide curves, which will be used as a guided curve in loft option. So click on front plane and then sketch on it. Now type here picture and then select sketch picture and import the top view. In the left side, in width option, type here 36 meter, which is the total length from this point to this point. It is the actual length of Boeing 737. Now align the origin with the nose. Press OK button now and then draw a center line. Start it from origin. Press escape button. Now draw a sketch according to these lines. For that, select spline and start it from origin. Press escape button and then select this spline and then this center line. Make their relation perpendicular. Readjust the spline points. Now draw a line and start it from this point. Again draw a spline, start it from this point up to this point. Press escape button. Now select mirror entities command from here and then select all these three entities. Then click on this box mirror about and then select the center line. Make sure this box is checked for copy. Press OK button. Now press this button to save and exit from sketch. So this is our top view. Now right click on the picture and then suppress it. For side view curves, select top plane and then sketch on it. Again search for picture, then select sketch picture and import the side view. Press OK button. Type here width 36 meter. Select flip vertically and then align the nose with the origin. Scale up the picture . Now press this button and then draw a sketch accordingly. Spline, start it from origin. Now draw a line. Select this line and then this line. Make their relation perpendicular. Now again subline and start it from this point. And once again line and start it from this point up to this point. One more line started from this point . Now select spline again and start it from this point. Select this line and then this line. Make their relation perpendicular. So sketch or guided curve for side view are also drawn. Now press this button to save and exit from sketch. Right click on the picture and then suppress it. Now go to Features tab and then select Curves, select Project Curve. Select this option Sketch on Sketch and then select this curve and this curve. Press OK button. Expand the curve tree and then select Sketch, then select Show and then unhide Sketch 1 also. Now we have to create multiple planes on these points. So for that, click on reference geometry and then select plane. Select right plane as first reference and then this point as second reference. Click on the right plane and then unhide it. Again select plane, select right plane as first reference and then this point as second reference. Press OK button. Again select plane, right plane as first reference and this point as second reference. Create the planes on all these points one by one. So now we had created planes on all these points. So first of all, click on this right plane and then sketch on it. Zoom in and you don't have to draw any sketch or ellipse on the right plane. You just have to place a point on the origin. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now you can hide the right plane, then sketch on plane 1, make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard. Right click on the curve and then hide it. Now select spline and then draw it like this. Press escape button and then select this curve and then this point. Select make pairs relation. Similarly select this curve and then this point. also make peers relation. Same for this point. So it is now fully defined. Now hide the plane 1 and then sketch on plane 2. Make normal 2 and repeat the same process for this plane. Select this curve and then this point, make the relation peers. Similarly for this curve, the relation is peers. Also for both of these curve and point. Save and exit from sketch. Do the same process for all these planes. Now again right click on this curve 1 and then unhide it. Select this point and then this curve. Select make peers. Similarly, select this curve and then this point, make peers. Then select this line and then this point, make peers. Select this line and then this point, make peers. Save and exit from sketch. Then hide this plane 8. Now last sketch on plane 9. Make normal 2 and then draw spline in the same way. Press escape button. And then make their relation peers. Peers and last this line with this point. Now our sketch is fully defined. Press this button to save and exit from sketch and hide this plane 9. Now it's time to apply lofted boss base command. So for that, click on lofted boss base command and then click on this box for profile. It would be difficult to select this point. So to select this point exactly, drop down this tree and then scroll down and then select sketch 3. Then select this circular profile. Now right click on the guide curve box and then select selection manager. Now select from here, select group and then select this curve. Press OK button. Press OK button to apply this command. Again select lofted boss base command and then select this circular profile, then this circular profile, and then right click on this box for guide curves, then select selection manager. Now select this curve, press OK button. Again select from here the selection manager and then select this guide curve. Press OK button. Once again select selection manager and then select this curve. Press OK button. Again select selection manager and then select this side curve. Press OK button. Now press OK button to apply this command. Do the same process for all these lofts, lofted boss base command, and then select both of the profiles one by one. Then right click on this box and then select selection manager. Select this curve, press OK button. Again right click and then select selection manager and then select this curve, press OK button, selection manager and then this curve, press OK button. Selection manager and then this curve, press OK button. Apply this command. So here is the problem that we had left the plane for this point. So again, I'm going to create the plane for this point. Right plane as a first reference and then this point as a second reference. Press OK button. Now sketch on this plane and then make normal to. Their relation pairs similarly for this joint and then this joint, the relation is pairs. Now hide this plane and then again apply a lofted boss base command. Selection manager and then select this curve. Press OK button. Again apply lofted boss base command and repeat the same process for the rest of the circular profiles. So now the fuselage is almost ready. Now we have to hide these lines or curves. Now to better view, click on display style and then select shaded. Unhide these sketches. Right click on the pictures and then unsuppress them. Unsuppress them. Now here you can see the fuselage of Boeing 737 has been designed according to the picture. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more. Thanks for watching and sparing time.